Thank you. case of Chile 40 years ago, go back to that, what Latin Americans call the first 9/11, Henry Kissinger explained that Chile under Allende, he said, is a virus that might spread contagion elsewhere, all the way to Southern Europe. He wasn't saying that Chilean troops were going to land in Rome. He was concerned, rightly, that the model of peaceful parliamentary democracy might spread, in which case the contagion would spread beyond and the U.S. system of domination would erode. The same was true in Vietnam. The primary motive for the Indochina wars, going back to the early 1950s, it was presented here as the domino theory. But what that meant was, if you read the internal records, that there was a fear, a justified fear, that successful independent development in Vietnam might spread through the region, might spread contagion through the region. Others would attempt the same path. Vietnam itself was of no great significance, but it might spread as far as Indonesia, which has rich resources, and there too there might be a move towards independent development, independent of U.S. domination. And it was even feared that that might bring in Japan. John Dower, the famous Asia historian, described Japan as the super domino. The U.S. was concerned, deeply concerned, that if Southeast Asia moved toward independent development, Japan would accommodate, the word that was used, to East and Southeast Asia becoming its technological industrial center and creating a system, an Asian system, in from which the U.S. would maybe not be excluded, but at least which it wouldn't control. Now, the U.S. had fought the Second World War to prevent that. That's Japan's new order. And it was in danger of being reconstituted if Indochina gained independence. That's the domino theory. And that was understood. George Bundy, Kennedy Johnson National Security Advisor, in retrospect, observed that the Vietnam War, the United States should have called off the Vietnam War in 1965. Why 1965? Well, because in 1965, a U.S.-backed military coup took place in Indonesia, slaughtering hundreds of thousands of people, wiping out the only mass-based political party, instituting a regime of torture and terror, but opening the country up to Western exploitation with its rich resources. And that meant that the Vietnam War was essentially over. The U.S. had won its main objectives. It was pointless to continue it. This policy is, these are major principles of world affairs, and they're understandable, and they're understood. So go back to Cuba again. When Kennedy came into office, he was concerned with changing Latin American policy. He developed the set up the Latin American Research Commission. It was headed by Arthur Schlesinger, as a historian, who was his advisor. And they came out with a report. It was presented by Schlesinger to the president. And in it, Schlesinger described the problem of Cuba. He said, the problem of Cuba is the Castro idea of taking matters into your own hands, an idea which may have resonance in other parts of Latin America, where the mass of the population is subjected to the same kind of harsh repression that they are in Cuba.